What's going on, TW fans? Thomas and his terrible mustache bringing you this week's episode of What's New at Tackle Warehouse. Winter is here. If you're anything like me, maybe you're wrapping up your duck season, starting to think about that spring bite, that pre-spawn bite, and we're staring at a bunch of baits, just getting our tackle ready, gearing up for the season. I'm excited. Let's show you some cool stuff to stock up on before the fish start biting again. All right, first up, I'm gonna start with a rod here, this time from Duckett Fishing. This is the Duckett Fishing Zeus series of rods. I got the casting rod in my hand, obviously. We also have a spinning rod series as well, so make sure you check them both out. I mean, let's just talk about the cosmetics on this thing first. It's a handsome looking rod, I'll say it. It's a cool, good looking rod. It's got this kind of cool pearlescent green watermelon red flake going on down the bottom. Kind of reminds me of those old Corrado E series reels. So just really cool cosmetics on this thing, but don't you worry, that's backed up by some performance as well. So we got halo sanded Sensi Touch blanks, so incredibly sensitive, but they also use a carbon scrim, so that's gonna, you know, not sacrifice any durability, so lightweight, sensitive, but still strong. It's not gonna break on you. Topped with some cool guides. It's their proprietary guides, the Keegan Artist 316 stainless steel guides with some braid-ready hyperlight rings on the inside of this thing. A lot of words to tell you that it casts great. It's gonna give you expert line management, quiet cast, and stand up to braid, just like the name says. So that whole guide train, you know, kind of small on there, but not quite micro size. So if you're using line-to-line connection knots, you know, braid to your fluorocarbon leader, whatever you're using, it's gonna go through those guides nice and easy. Keeper system up front here in front of the handles. Let's talk about the handles themselves. Got a nice EVA foam grip on these things, split grip, and then it's bookended by this rubberized cork wraps. So just kind of a nice look, good all-weather feel. And then you have, you know, exposure under the reel seat here, so just a ton of sensitivity. So lightweight, well-balanced, comes in at like 130 bucks, I think. So I think this really kind of hits above its price point. Just a lot of performance for not a lot of dollars. I like that. Now, speaking of a lot of dollars, we got a new flagship reel from Lures. This thing is sweet. This is the Team Lures Elite TI SLP casting reel. I mean, look at it, it's awesome. It looks like, I don't know, a spaceship and a race car had a baby, and then that baby was adopted by Iron Man and RoboCop. It's just cool looking, I like it. It's really nice, and that's kind of what I expect from a flagship reel. You know, I'm not real brand loyal. I like a lot of things, I try a lot of things, but I do kind of lean towards Daiwa and Shimano. I think this thing is really gonna compete with their flagship reels as well. So it does come in at like 500 bucks. So this thing is definitely their top dog as far as reels concerned, but they back that thing up with a ton of performance. So the performance itself, the internals of this thing, 11 bearing system combines with their super P2 pinion and then hardened aluminum gears. So really, really smooth performance. This thing feels nice when you're cranking with it. So you're getting a ton of performance out of it. The body itself, it's titanium coated aluminum. So it comes in at like 6.2 ounces. I thought maybe it'd be a little bit lighter, but it's still 6.2 ounces. That's not that heavy. I don't notice it. It's real nice. It looks real pretty as well. But in addition to all those, you know, core features that you expect from that flagship reel, they have a ton of auxiliary features that are really cool. So they have their speed knot system in their spool. So rather than having to use, you know, electrical tape, medical tape, whatever trick you're using to attach your line to your spool, they have their little speed knot system. You just tie a knot in the end of your line, you slip it in the notch, and it just holds on there, and you can just spool up your reel quick and easy. So especially for the tournament guys that are changing out line a little bit more often than the rest of us, that's gonna be a really nice feature as well. On the handle side, we have these sweet 95 millimeter carbon fiber bowed handles. So nice, strong, large, lightweight handle that I like. And then they're cool WinTac Pro Weave grips on these things. So these knobs, super, super nice. They kind of remind me of like Cashin's carbon fiber handles. So kind of similar to that, but it's actually wind grip material. So all weather performance, really comfortable, have a little bit of a squish to them. So it's kind of nice. It just gives you a nice secure grip to them. So you have also a line ID feature on here. So you're never gonna forget what pound test fluorocarbon monofilament braid that you have on there. That line ID feature is really nice. And then they also have their hook keeping system right on the inside of the body of this reel. So if unfortunately you're using a rod that doesn't have a hook keeper system, or maybe that keeper is down on the handle and you like it more up in front of your reel, Lures has got you covered with that. So a ton of convenience features, a ton of performance on this one, a really cool flagship reel from Lures. You're gonna wanna check out that. That's the Elite TI SLP casting reel. Got another one for you. So another ton of performance, but not quite the dollars on it. So this is another nice, more budget-friendly reel. This is the Mach 2 SLP casting reel. Nice low profile design. We got a graphite body and frame. So you're getting that lightweightness to it. but it still has a ton of performance, ton of power to it. So 15 pounds of drag on that Elite one. We actually had 20 pounds of drag. I forgot to mention that. So you're gonna get a little bit less drag on this one, but still a ton of performance. 10 bearing system, nice smooth Hamai CNC machine gears. So it's just a really nice, smooth, powerful performance with that 15 pounds of drag, and just a good one. A little bit more budget friendly, gonna match up with these cool cosmetics to any of your mock rods that you might be using, but definitely wanna check out these two casting reels before the season kicks off. We got a new swim bait from Imakatsu. This is the Imakatsu Lazy Swimmer. This thing is gonna be killer for winter time because you can crawl this thing really, really, really slow with this awesome little tail. I mean, look, it basically folds over on itself. It's so soft. So we're actually gonna start by talking about this tail. So it comes to a really aggressive taper here. So it's just gonna allow it to give a nice, subtle, natural kick, kind of like a Huddleston wobble, if you will, when you're just dragging this thing through the water column super, super slow. Really natural looking, I like it a lot. If you wanna add some extra action to it, you can actually snip this tail along the lateral line here horizontally, and it'll just add an auxiliary action to it. You'll get kind of like a dual fluttering kick to it. But just a really natural looking bait, all the soft fins really bring this thing to life in the water column. I got a nice jig hook on top here, and then you have this hanging treble system. So you can actually pop this one off, but if you find the fish are short striking, you know, when you're only fishing this one at the top of the water column, not around a bunch of snaggy cover or along the bottom, you can pop that thing off or leave it on, whatever's gonna suit your needs best. But this Lazy Swimmer is awesome for really dragging this thing slowly back to the boat, which can be key in this wintertime when you're dealing with lethargic fish that are looking for that easy meal. This might be the one you wanna turn to. Ton of great colorways that you can choose from on this one, and just awesome great detailing. You know, I talked about those soft fins earlier, but you know, you have 3D checkered scales on here, you have gill plates on the side, these nice eyes, mandibles up front. So just a really natural looking swim bait with killer natural action. You're gonna wanna check it out for this winter and of course beyond. I think this thing's gonna get a ton of bites. All right, let's take a look at Taku Itu's new worm. From Nories, we got the Nories Laddery Nico Rig Worm. I mean, Elite Series angler, Taku Itu, finesse master, he knows a thing or two about worms. This worm is no exception, it's awesome. Another really tremendously soft bait, kind of like that Lazy Swimmer we were just looking at. I mean, on the dead stick, this thing is gonna give you a ton of action with just how soft that plastic is. It is still durable as well though, so you're not gonna tear it up after just one fish or two, but this thing gives you a ton of action. So in the name, Nico Rig Worm, that is kind of what it's geared for. You have this flat bottom here that's gonna be perfect for accepting your favorite nail weight, be it tungsten, you know, half moon weight or something to insert all the way. This thing is, that's what it's kind of made for, that Nico Rig technique. But it doesn't stop there. You can absolutely use it on a shaky head, drop shot. I mean, it's actually relatively heavy for how small it is thanks to that plastic design to it. So you can even throw this thing weightless. Ton of things you can do with this worm. A bunch of micro ribbing from head to tail, so you're gonna get subtle vibration out of it. It's gonna grab a little bit more of that water and just gonna give more of a natural mouthfeel for the bass. But just a tremendous little finesse worm coming from the finesse master himself. You're gonna wanna check it out. You know, it can be hard to get those bites in the wintertime and when the fishing's just tough in general, pressured lakes. That's gonna be one you wanna check out. All right, now let's check out a shape that everyone knows. This is the Strike King Ratlin Rage Craw. The Rage Craw has been popular for a long, long time, has their patented Rage Tail technology, which, you know, ton of fluttering, kicking, a lot of action, pretty unique action to it as well. Well, now they got us covered with a rattling version. I mean, this thing's pretty loud. For a lot of soft plastics, when they incorporate that rattle in there, yeah, I can kind of hear it, but this one, I was surprised at how loud this rattle is. So that's really nice. If you're fishing, you know, stained water, dirty water, heavy cover, maybe some low light conditions or night fishing itself, that's just gonna help call in those predators a little bit better, help those bass locate your jig or just the plastic itself, if you're Texas rigging, Carolina rigging it, in those hard to see conditions. Still getting those great colors, you know, I have a green pumpkin, kind of watermelon red color right here. So killer colors that we're used to from Strike King. You got that coffee scent to it, that classic, like I mentioned earlier, that Rage Tail technology, and just this nice craw profile, but now we're getting a little bit of an acoustic layer of attraction to it as well. So definitely add this one to your arsenal for those kind of challenging conditions where the fish can't really see your bait as well. All right, got another unique one for you here. This one's from Mustad. This is the Mustad Arm Lock Double Willow Spinnerbait. I mean, it's a pretty unique, one-of-a-kind spinnerbait here with this arm lock design, which we'll talk about in a second. But just overall, this wire shape, you can kind of see we run parallel to the hook above here with this flat part of the arm, but then it has this little curve, which is gonna enhance the vibration on these willow blades. And these willow blades, they're kind of carefully bent to really spin and throw a lot of light as you're running this thing, whether it's, you know, slowly burning it across the surface, you know, deep rolling it down below. It's just, you're gonna get a ton of flash out of these things. And then we come down here to this double arm lock design. So that's just meant to really bolster the strength of this thing. So you're gonna be able to swing that rod in confidence. You're gonna get a ton of good positive hookups with this thing. If you're chasing, you know, trophy class fish, or maybe you're fishing around heavy cover and you need to keep those fish away from the cover, this is gonna be the spinnerbait you wanna turn to, because it is just a ton of muscle to keep those fish pinned and keep them away from any snaggy cover. The head itself features kind of a unique eye system. So they're like clear eyes. You can actually see through them. It almost looks like if you wave your finger in front of it or behind it, it almost looks like there's an eye in there looking around. So as you're kind of running this spinnerbait along, you know, past some cover, it's gonna give it more of a natural lifelike eye appearance to it. Right behind that head, which has a durable paint on it, that's gonna kind of resist some chipping, we have a hand-tied silicone skirting system. I love it when it's hand-tied, especially if a bass somehow just grabs a hold of the skirting. It's not gonna get ripped off or displaced. You're gonna be able to keep fishing this thing. Nice little subtle keeper system on here for your swim bait, so it's not gonna tear up, or, you know, if you're using a curly tail, whatever you're putting on the back of this thing, it's not going to tear that plastic up at all. And then a really, really nice hook. So again, great positive hookups with the new arm lock spinnerbait from Mustad. All right, it's winter time. We can't talk winter time without some jig fishing. We got some new ones from Cumberland Pro Lures. First up is the Buckshot football jig. So a nice football head design on here. Great for coming through rocky cover, kind of those snaggier situations. That football head design just kind of holds up a little bit better, or just comes through without snagging as much, I guess I should say. But also adds a ton of action on this one. So you have a 90 degree hook on this one here. So again, that's gonna kind of enhance that rocking, wobbling action, kind of put those crawfish, if you're using a crawfish trailer, in the defensive posture that bass simply can't resist. So you're getting a ton of action to it. Has a little semi-recessed line tie on here. So just give your knot a little bit of protection if you're fishing around abrasive rocky cover, which are awesome, or often are with these football heads. And then nice silicone skirting on the back, a hook keeper system, and then a great weed guard on here. So it collapses really easy, not gonna interfere with your hook sets, but it's still gonna shed some of that snaggy vegetation. So a cool football jig to check out. Another one from Cumberland Pro Lures, we have their Lil Runt Finesse ball head. This thing's cool. So it's kind of, the ball head's been around forever, everyone knows that. Well, this is Cumberland Pro, their take on that ball head. I like the head a lot because they actually incorporated this little flat section on the back, so it's just gonna sit upright. It's not gonna roll on you like some of those other ball heads. It'll actually stay upright. One that's gonna help you come through those rocky covers better. But when you, if you're fishing this thing slow and you let it come to rest on the bottom, it'll keep your hook point up. So you're gonna snag less and you're gonna have better optimized hookup ratios because your hook is where it's supposed to be pointing up. So a cool little finesse ball head with this flat section on the bottom you're gonna wanna check out from Cumberland. All right, we got one from Buddha Baits, the Buddha Baits Enlightened Tungsten Football Shaky Head. A lot of words in that one as well. I mean, it's a shaky head with a football head design. That's great. Again, if you're working some of those chunk rock, small boulders, just rocky shorelines, that's where this thing is gonna excel. It's gonna hang up a little bit less. And since it's tungsten, it's gonna give you a smaller profile, really dense profile, so it's gonna increase your sensitivity. Got a nice keeper system on here, so maybe you were using that Nories worm on this one, or hey, the Strike King Rage Craw, that Rattlin' Rage Craw, it's gonna thread on there really well and stay pinned to the back of it. Nice Mustad Aberdeen jig hook on this thing. So again, really rock solid hook sets on this thing. You're gonna be able to swing that rod in confidence. So if you're looking for a new shaky head, something with that football head design, check out this new one from Buddha Baits. Last product we're talking about today, a piece of terminal from VMC. This is the VMC Straight Shank Wide Gap Hook. A couple of guys in the office were laughing about this thing. It looks like you can wacky rig a hot dog on it. So you got that extra wide gap on this thing, which is perfect for using your oversized plastics. Maybe you're targeting trophy bass with those magnum worms, or even a creature bait that you want to wacky rig. This wide gap is just gonna accommodate those bulky plastics while still giving you plenty of room for a great hook set. Kind of that medium heavy wire design, so you're able to fish this thing around some of those, you know, kind of mid to heavy covers, or use some heavier lines or light braid, heavier fluorocarbon. It's still gonna hold up just fine, not bend out, not break, not snap on you. So if you're one of those anglers that likes using oversized plastic and have been looking for an oversized wacky hook, check out this new one from VMC. All right, guys, that's gonna wrap up this week's episode of What's New at Tackle Warehouse. As always, thank you for tuning in and checking out these products. And to learn more about them or shop for them, make sure to click shop or the link in the description below. If you enjoyed this week's video, you wanna see more just like it, do not forget to subscribe to our channel and let us know in the comments below which one of these you wanna put to use to this winter, beyond, whatever. You think this reel is cool? I think it's cool. Let us know, we wanna hear from you. All right, we'll see y'all next week.